Say it with me now. Feet, body, head. Yeah, so consider this t-shirt a hint for the next Geek Me 5 episode. Howdy, hey there, and hello. I'm Montez McCrary, at Tezo Nerdo from thepractitioner.com, and on this episode of Geek Me 5, we'll be discussing 5 simple and interesting facts about the classic Nickelodeon game show, Legends of the Hidden Temple. Anyways, let's get nerdy.
1.
According to host Kirk Fogg, the first episode took nearly 18 hours to shoot due to the more than the expected production hangups and the fact that the show's elaborate set and physical challenges were pretty difficult to coordinate, which resulted in the inaugural contestants, you know, just crying and exhausted. But eventually, once the show got into the groove of things, the average shooting day dwindled down from 18 hours to a far more manageable 12 hours.
2.
Legendary voice actor Dee Bradley Baker was the voice of Olmec, the giant 6-foot-tall faux stone head who served as somewhat of a co-host to Fogg by narrating the proceedings and offering pretty underwhelming advice to the contestants. Now, he was one of the temple's most memorable elements. In fact, Baker actually stood inside Olmec's head with a microphone, a script, and a lever to move the statue's mouth. And whenever he wasn't talking, he would just be kicking back, reading the book, waiting until it was his time to say his lines. Quick hit. Speaking of Olmec, which is likely a nod to the Olmec, a civilization that predated the Maya and made giant stone heads. But anyway, in 2002, while Nickelodeon was clearing out its props and its sets from the 90s at their Universal Studios location, one former staffer told author Matthew Klickstein for his book Slimed, An Oral History of Nickelodeon, that Olmec's foam rubber head was up for sale. And he said that he really wanted to buy it, but then he said that his wife probably would have killed him.
3.
Approximately 15% of the contestants cried after being frightened by the temple guards. So here's how it goes if you're not familiar. Should a team successfully pass the show's first 3 rounds, including the awesome Steps of Knowledge and crossing that giant moat, Steps of Knowledge for the freaking win? Anyway, they took part in the temple obstacle course, which was basically a confusing maze of puzzles, rooms, and temple guards that would pop out of practically anywhere to terrify the tired children. One former contestant, Keely, told SBNation.com in 2013 that she was reduced to tears, saying, "I'm 31 and I can't go to haunted houses. I'm deathly afraid of things popping out of closets and doors." And another contestant got so upset when they got startled that she vomited in the pit of despair, which was basically the ball pit. Ugh, it's like the McDonald's play place all over again. I really don't get it. It's the feet, the body, then the head. I don't know.
4.
Not only was host Kirk Fogg hired at random, the contestants were also teamed up randomly, as Fogg told BuzzFeed that he was pretty much chosen at random from a headshot catalog, then asked to audition by reading some play-by-play from a teleprompter, and later earned his very first hosting gig. Now, on the other side, according to a few former contestants, including one named Anthony, the two-person teams were selected by herding numerous kids into a staging area where a single production assistant would then randomly start pairing them together, where they would later have to quickly change into their team uniforms, get acquainted with one another, get along with each other, or not.
5.
While the show won a Cable Ace Award from the National Academy of Cable Programming in 1995, for best game show special or series, the show's producers didn't let many of the kids win, as Fogg told Great Big Story in 2016 that the reason only 30 odd teams wound up finishing the final obstacle course out of the show's 120 episodes was that the producers didn't really have the budget to award the grand prize to too many kids. So the Temple Run was designed specifically, intentionally, to be really difficult so they wouldn't exceed their 8 grand prizes per season maximum quota. But still, it's feet first, body second, head last. Why was that so freaking hard to understand? For more about Legends of the Hidden Temple, check out Matthew Klickstein's book, Slimed, An Oral History of Nickelodeon's Golden Age, Kirk Fogg's interview with BuzzFeed from 2013, and just loads and loads of videos of the show on YouTube from the Unknown Archive. Before we close, I'm Montez McCrary at TezelNerdo from thepractitioner.com, and thank you very much for your time. Please like, share, and subscribe. Follow The Practitioner on all the social networks. Shop at The Practitioner Zazzle Store and our affiliate links. And remember to stay true to yourself. Stay blessed and stay nerdy. That was the most frustrating part, that they would, it's like they'd like, look at yourself, your feet are down here, your body's here, and your head is up here.